All right, so we should probably get started. This is just me assembling a little arch lamp that I found on Thingiverse. The sections get assembled very simply. They just slide together. And then these feet they connect on the end. And then we're going to put this LED strip up inside. We'll give it some juice. We'll see what happens. I have some concerns over this LED strip. I don't know if you can see how close. Let me give some light. How close those LEDs are to one another. My concern is that it might get too hot for the plastic, which is only PLA. So, the proof of the pudding is in the eating, right? Let's get to it. First things first, we're going to clean up some of these pieces. So, I've already removed the supports, the printing supports from a couple of them. We're just gonna make sure that the edges are nice. It's a bit of a gouge. I recently replaced the nozzle on the printer. In fact, I replaced it for these last two pieces, and there is a little bit, you won't be able to see, but there's a little bit of an elephant's foot, so we're just going to clean that up real quick. Yeah, we'll call that nice. Let's clean this one up. All right, well, I can just use my nail for that. Excellent. All right, let's get started on this one. Need a better tool. Thank you. So while I was printing this piece, I ran out of gray filament. Had to do an emergency changeover. All I had left was white, so I don't think the bicolor looks too bad. We'll clean off this little bit. And this one. Well, it doesn't want to come out of there. All right. That's four pieces cleaned up. Let's take care of the mess. And let's start putting these together. So, it should just be a matter of sliding them. Just doesn't want to, does it? Let's see if I have something to persuade it with. With which to persuade it. How's that? Still not happy with that one. The There's a lip inside. I'm trying to get those. As close as possible. Let's get it. See if a straight edge will help. Hey, look at that. All right. So there is the arch. The feet will just slide onto the ends. However, I think I'm going to need to clean this one up a little bit. On this one here, I had to file a little bit of a chamfer on the edge, so I'm just going to assume the second one will require the same treatment. Let's clean that inside edge. Nice. So that one fits. That one will also fit with some light persuading. Let's see how much LED strip we're going to need. I don't want to put the LEDs all the way down into the feet, so it looks like I am going to cut them just a few centimeters short on either side. Let's see how that will look. I think we're going to cut it right there on that cut mark. Excellent. Now the channel is a bit wide. I'm not so concerned. I think we're gonna center it right like that. I think that'll work well, and just make a quick mark so we know. All right. I'm going to take the backing off, starting in the middle. And I'm not going to worry about centering it in the channel, I don't think. I'll just have it pushed up against one edge. It should be fine. Let's start pulling off the backing. That looks like a winner. And we'll get the other side. Oh, that also looks like a winner. All right.
Trash.
And
we need a pigtail.
All right, so that pigtail will feed up through the hole in the base. And then I'll tie it off in some way. Add a stress relief, something. Maybe I'll just fill that hole up with some hot glue. Let's see how bright it gets. Grab a couple clips. To my, oh, that's not going to be long enough. We can daisy chain them. We're good. So I got the T-pins, so I can be a little bit more accurate. Ooh. Yeah. I think that's going to be nice. Mm-hmm. So let's get the soldering iron prepared. Somewhere around this mess, I have a battery. Well, I can't locate the one that I built for the purpose, so I'll just use the drone pack. It'll suffice. Grab some solder and bring out the iron. Heats up pretty quickly. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this, because it is very slippery. Woo, barely fits under the camera mount. All right, and I know these leads are pre-tinned. So it should simply be a matter of heating those up and letting them reflow. Let's see if we can do that. got a hair stuck on my soldering iron. Alright, so those were probably tinned with lead-free solder. So let's put some good stuff on there. All right, take two. All right, well, that looks like it worked. Let's seat that down in. And we'll do the other side. All right, so the person who came up with this design made it for working on nails. So when you're having your nails prepared, the preparer can have adequate lighting. Let's get a wall wart. Turn this on. I think an amp will probably be good. If we can find one. course, one immediately wonders if this is the right bin. Let's see, what is this? 12-volt 3-amp. Well, moment of truth. All right, now this plastic, when I print it at 200 degrees, but it does become pliant lower than that. I printed a thing and left it in my car in the sun, and it started to deform. So I'm not sure how hot these lights are going to get. Over time, they may heat up. Time will tell. Anyway, successful test. Let's get the hot glue and plug that hole, give it a bit of strain relief. Trying to see the wattage on this gun. 40. It's going to take forever to get hot. So be it. Hey, Pad. I wasn't paying attention to chat. Nice to see you. Yeah. The lamp gets older as I do, and will deform possibly. Time will tell, but I'm pretty pleased with it. The adhesive seems to be not the greatest on this strip, but in my experience, once the adhesive heats up, it will get better. It will adhere more. We'll see. I played with other strips, and that is the situation. That glue just becomes like contact cement once it comes up to temperature. So while we wait for the glue gun to warm up, I've got a couple other things that I've been working on. These are some circuit boards that I had made. Designed these and made those. I solder onto them all these connectors and MOSFETs and resistors and whatnot. And what they let me do is connect 12-volt, 3.3-volt, and ground on the three-way connector. And I've got a positive-negative on the other connector. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense because it's an N-type MOSFET, so there really is no positive. But either way, how this works is I take my pre-flashed ESP8266 and I can just plug it right in and wire that into a project. Like, let me see what I've got to step across the room. All right, so I 3D printed two of these Minecraft torches. There's a little cleat. So it can be screwed to a wall. And then the torch hangs on over the top. And this bit at the top is translucent. So I will put some LEDs in the top. Put one of these connectors, of course without the T-pins, I use those for alligator clamps, down inside. And then I'll have the power pigtail running out the bottom. And I've got some code running. I run two Minecraft servers for another streamer. And I've got a little code running on them, so when someone is logged in, anyone, when there are users on the server, it communicates with my home automation system, and I can tell it to turn the lights on. So I will have one light for the modded server and one light for vanilla, and when somebody logs in, the torch will light up. I've still got to get them painted, but pretty pleased so far. See if that gun is warm. Yeah, it's getting there. Let's get those out the way. Bring this over where you can see it and give it a bit of the goo. No wonder they call this stuff hot snot. All right. Well, that is that. Put the tools off to the side. Let's, trying to see if I have anything that glue might not adhere to. It certainly likes to adhere to fingers. Should have it up closer to where you guys can see. Wedge it down in there a little bit. I'll try to pretty it up. However, I'm going to call that a success. I will send it. I was going to use this for my streaming so I could have adequate light. However, it is obviously far too small. So I am going to take it downstairs to my wife's soap factory. And when she takes photos, she'll be able to have nice lighting. Well, just a little bit of cleanup, and I think we will shut this whole thing down, and I will get on to something else. Thanks.